Hello friends, first of all thanks for being here in my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about the diseases of crucifers. First disease, that is club root of crucifers or finger and toe disease. Club root, it is also called as finger and toe disease. It is caused by Plasmodiophora brassicae. It is the causal organism. Let me discuss the symptoms. Infected plants have pale green to yellowish leaves initially. Later, infected plant show wilting in the middle of hot sunny days, recovering during the night. Stunting of above ground parts and reduction in size of hairs. Characteristic symptoms become apparent in advanced stage of root infection as spindle-like, spherical, knobby or club-shaped swelling. The swelling may be few or they coalesce and cover the entire root system. The coalesce means what? The adjacent area also become swelled, become larger, and two such places come together and become larger one. This situation is called coalesion. In case of different diseases, there are that are exhibiting the spots, the different size of spots on the leaves. Gradually, day by day, they are becoming larger one, and at one day they become larger one by mixing in each other. That situation is called coalesion. Disease cycle. It is primary source of infection. Soil-borne resting spores which survive for longer periods in soil, that is up to 10 years. Collateral host, broccoli, Brussels sprout, cabbage, cauliflower, Chinese cabbage, mustard, radish and turnip. These are the collateral hosts. Then secondary infection by means of resting spores or zoospores carried through irrigation water or by root contacts. Let me discuss about the favorable conditions. This disease occurs at a temperature range of 12 to 27 degrees Celsius. Next, that is high soil moisture, means if there is a waterlogging condition in the field, then it favors the incidence of this one disease. Neutral to acidic soils, that is pH range from 5 to 7. These are the favorable conditions for occurrence of the disease. Management, use of seedlings from disease free fields. This is very important and this is the preventive measures. Plant cabbage and other susceptible cruciferous crops in well drained fields that have a pH slightly above neutral. Crop rotation does not work since pathogen persists long in soil. Next, add hydrated lime to soil to increase pH to 7.2, that is 6 weeks before planting at the rate 2.5 ton per hectare. Avoid excess irrigation. If you prefer the excess irrigation, then there will be a waterlogging condition and ultimately the soil moisture will be increased and that is very susceptible condition for the development of disease or pathogen. Next, treat the soil of seed bed area with chloropicrin or methyl bromide or VAPM 2 weeks before planting. Drenching soil with solution of ब्रासिकॉल, इट इज़ वेरी इफेक्टिव फॉर कंट्रोलिंग द क्लब रूट डिसीज. सेकेंड डिसीज दैट इज डाउनी मिल्ड्यू, इट इज कॉज्ड बाय पेरनोस्पोरा पैरासिटिका, द कॉजल ऑर्गेनिज्म फॉर द डाउनी मिल्ड्यू. दिस डिसीज इज सीवियर इन रेडिश, कैबेज, कॉलीफ्लावर, मस्टर्ड एंड नॉल खोल. सिम्टम्स, लेट मी डिस्कस अबाउट द सिम्टम्स. स्मॉल पर्पलिश ब्राउन स्पॉट ऑन अंडर सर्फेस ऑफ लीव्स, दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड डाउनी मिल्ड्यू. द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ स्पॉट अंडर द लीफ सर्फेस, दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज डाउनी मिल्ड्यू. नेक्स्ट, स्मॉल पेल येलो एंग्यूलर स्पॉट्स ऑन अपर सर्फेस ऑफ लीव्स विथ डाउनी ग्रोथ ऑन द अंडर सर्फेस. द स्पॉट्स कोलीज एंड द लीव्स श्रिवेल एंड ड्राइज अप प्रीमैच्योरली. कोलिजन मीन्स टू एडजेसेंट स्पॉट बिकम कम टुगेदर एंड बिकम लार्जर वन. दैट सिचुएशन और दैट एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ सिम्टम्स इज कॉल्ड एज कोलिजन. नेक्स्ट सिम्टम, इन कैबेज दीज स्पॉट्स एक्सपोज द हेड्स टू सॉफ्ट रॉट. कॉलीफ्लावर कर्ड्स लुक ब्राउनिश एट द टॉप. स्टेम्स शो डार्क ब्राउन एंड डिप्रेस्ड लीजन्स और स्ट्रीक्स विच लेटर डेवलप डाउनी ग्रोथ ऑफ फंगस. दीज आर द कॉमन सिम्टम्स एंड दिस डिसीज इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट. यू कैन सी द सिम्टम्स इन दीज टू पिक्चर्स. लेट मी डिस्कस द डिसीज साइकिल, दैट इज प्राइमरी सोर्स ऑफ इन्फेक्शन. Oospores in infected plant parts or in soil. Then secondary source of infection, that is wind-borne sporangia. Management of the disease, destruction of infected plant debris, that is collection and destroy the plant debris which are infected and which are fallen on the ground in the growing area. Suddenly we will have to collect that one and eradicate from the field. Avoidance of thick sowing and excessive moist conditions. Next point, spray metalaxyl at the rate 0.25% or COC, that is copper oxychloride at 0.3% or mancozeb at 0.2% at 10 days interval. See here, the metalaxyl, this is highly recommended or specially recommended for controlling or for managing the oospores. As the primary infection or the primary source of infection is oospores, then we must apply or we must follow the spraying with metalaxyl. It will give the better result. Next disease, the powdery mildew. Erysipelae polygoni, it is the causal organism. Symptom, these symptoms can be observed on cabbage and cauliflower. Let me discuss point wise. White powdery spot on the upper surface of leaves, stems, flowers and another parts of the plant. Finally, the mildew may cover the entire surface. As we discussed in various diseases, especially powdery mildew, the same appearance of that disease on different plant parts, that is grayish powdery growth we can observe on the leaf, on the inflorescence, on the fruits, on the stems, etc. Here also you can see in these pictures, the leaves are exhibiting the symptoms of having the growth of powdery mildew. Disease cycle, the primary source of infection, that is mycelium in infected plant debris. This is the strong source of primary source infection. Then next, that is the secondary source of infection, that is wind-borne conidia. Management, application of DinoCap at the rate 0.2%. This is all about the chemical treatment, but farmer must adopt all the management practices that are cultural management practices, biological management practices, legal methods, etc. Next disease, that is Alternaria leaf spot. It is caused by Alternaria brassicola, Alternaria brassici, or Alternaria raphani. Common on cabbage, cauliflower, and mustard. This disease you can observe on cabbage, cauliflower, and mustard crop. Let me discuss symptoms. Spots are small and dark colored. They enlarge, soon become circular and 1 mm in diameter. Under a humid condition, groups of conidiophores will be formed in the spot. If there is a humid situation, then there is a production, the higher production of conidiophores in groups. You can observe in the spot. Spot develop concentric rings. This is very characteristic symptom of Alternaria leaf spot. Whenever you study the Alternaria disease in that particular crop, you can observe this characteristic symptom, that is concentric rings develop on the leaf. Next, finally the spot's coli is leading to the lighting of next point. The fungus is seed-borne and cause shriveling of seeds and poor germination. Means the fungus is basically seed-borne, then obviously it affects the seeds. It shrivels the seeds and reduces the germination percentage of that seed for a great extent. Next, linear spots also appear on petioles, stems, pods, and seeds. These are the common symptoms. Let me discuss disease cycle. Primary source of infection, mycelium persisting in the seed or as spores on seed or from debris. Secondary source of infection, wind or insect borne conidia. Let me discuss management. Hot water treatment at 50 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. As it is the seed borne fungus, that's why the hot water treatment will act as very important management practices. Next point, seed treatment with Agrosan. Again, we can apply the seed treatment because the fungus is seed borne in nature. If we sow the healthy seeds or treated seeds, then there will be a less chance of incidence of this one Alternaria disease. Next, foliar spray with mancozeb at the rate 0.2% or COC, that is copper oxychloride, at the rate 0.3% twice. Next disease, that is black rot. Xanthomonas campestris, Pathover campestris. It is basically the bacterial disease, and it is serious on cabbage, cauliflower, novel kohl, mustard, and radish. Let me discuss the symptoms. First appear near the leaf margins as chlorotic or yellow areas. In previous lecture or in previous video, I have already explained the meaning of chlorotic lesions. It is nothing but the loss of chlorophyll from the region, that may be from leaf, and that lesion or spot is called as chlorotic. The next point, the yellow areas extend to veins and midrib, forming characteristic V-shaped chlorotic spots. This is the characteristic symptom of black rot disease. Veins and veinlet turn brown and finally black. There is a variation in the color of the veins. Initially it becomes brownish and finally it turns to the black. The vascular blackening extends beyond affected veins to midrib, petiole, and stem. In advanced stages, infection may reach the root system and blackening of vascular bundles occurs. Bacterial ooze can also be seen on affected parts. If the infection is early, the plant wilt and dies. If the infection is late, plant succumb to soft rot and dies. Let me discuss about the disease cycle. Bacterium is internally seed borne and soil borne in nature. It also survives on plant debris. Next, collateral host, Centella asiatica. Bacteria enter through stomata of cotyledons, also enters through hadathodes on leaf margins and also through wounds. Secondary source of infection, bacterium through irrigation water or wind splash drain, and also by mechanical means. Let me discuss about the management. Seed treatment with HgCl2 solution for 30 minutes or agrimycin or oromycin 0.01%. Hot water treatment at 50 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes for killing seed borne inoculum, followed by 30 minute deep in streptocycline 100 parts per million. Spraying of agromycin 100 or streptocycline 50 parts per million at transplanting, curd formation and pod formation. Crop rotation for 2 to 3 years with non-cruciferous crop. It is very important. Drenching seedbed with 5% formalin or any antibiotic solution in nursery bed. Following are the resistant varieties of cabbage: Cabaret, Defender, Gladiator, Pusa Mukta. These are the resistant varieties. And about cauliflower, following are the resistant varieties, that is Pusa Ice, Pusa Snowball, KIF, and Cell 1-2. Thank you.